After more than 6 months, peace talks between the major powers have just broken off. After an hour and a half of a planned three-hour session this morning, members of both delegations stalked out of the conference room. Grim-faced, none of the delegates would speak to reporters, so at this point it is only conjecture as to what caused the rupture. But the disagreement, obviously, was serious. Confidential sources close to the talks report...
Save the lights.
People, come over here. Come over here. Okay, look. Fine. That was very good. We heard the radio report, and everybody was very nonchalant about that. We've heard that same report 1,000 times. Nobody's going to bomb us. There's nothing going to go on, and everybody was very natural. But look, when the bomb goes off, it's the real thing. You'll feel the heat, you'll hear the noise eventually, it'll be absolutely incredible. Larry, don't eat your donut. You've never seen anything in your life like it.
But I'm hungry.
But you're hungry, I know, okay. The important thing is the reaction. There's a horrible, horrible disaster, and somehow or another we're gonna have to portray it in your faces,
you
folks.
Not run out of food.
The first day on the set, the moment of truth, so to speak, when the director and writer and producer finally gets a chance to see their ideas translated into the film medium.
Okay, very good. Okay.
Get Stuart. Get somebody else to get it for you.
Most often, however, the start of a new production provides these unexpected moments of sheer frustration.
Hold it. Cut. Try it again. And change your aim. Congratulations, you finally made it. Okay, very good now. Allison, not too soon. Okay, now. Grab it.
For us, the challenge to create a film about nuclear disaster is probably the most difficult in the Your Chance to Live series. We feel as if the audience is quite apathetic about the potential and reality of a real nuclear attack.
Okay, let's get reaction shots now. React! More! Keep reacting. Come on now. Good. Come on, look serious. Okay, who's next? Hey, Larry. Okay, Larry. Oh, Larry, come on, look serious. Look scared.
Okay, let's get some more reaction shots. Larry.
Can
we get Allison?
Yeah.
Can we get Allison, George?
No, I think we need one of Allison.
Okay, let's get Allison. Okay. It's 14. Okay, Alice, we want you to look scared as if the bomb just went off. Can you do that, sweetheart?
Yeah.
Okay?
I'm not really scared.
You're not really scared?
Yeah, I do.
Do you know what a bomb is?
Yes, of course I do.
What is a bomb?
It's a thing that goes up in the air and comes down and kills people.
Okay. I'll tell you what. Marilyn, I don't want to use her. She's too precious. Okay, you ready, Neil?
Ready.
Okay. Light, Paul, you're okay?
Yeah.
Okay, look. Okay, starting positions.
At last, after 3 days of location photography, we were finally ready to analyze the footage in preparation for writing the narration script.
Here comes the new animation.
Looks good, good. What direction will the script take here?
Well, first we ought to talk about radiation and then fallout shelters.
Yeah, good. That should fall about here. And here we'll talk about how to stock a fallout shelter, I assume.
Yeah, we'll pick that point up right about here.
Yeah, I think we should pick it up right about here. It'd be much better. Looks nice. What follows will be the sequence dealing with supplying the shelter with basic necessities, I assume.
Right. We'll pick that up here.
Good. Speed it up, Elsa, will you please?
Let's hear the audio track with the sirens, please.
Okay. devastating, isn't it? Well, let's see what happens when Peter Thomas gets his hands on the narration. He'll make it sing.
Okay, Peter, let's take that section again. Let's take it from the top. Same emotion. It's pretty good.
You want to put the change in this time or wait for the next take?
Let's do it this time.
I'd like to ask you about the interpretation. There are two or three ways we could do this, like a prophet of doom. We could do it like a reporter and sort of factual, or maybe underplay it, very casual. But the words are so frightening, I'm not sure which way to go on this. What do you think?
I think we better do it softly. I'm afraid I don't want to scare them in the beginning. This narration's over the beginning of the film.
Yeah.
And later on, we'll scare the hell out of them. But let's do it low-key now.
Underplay. I got you. Okay. No time problem?
No.
A warning that hopefully will never be heard, but one which should be familiar, is a series of 3 to 5 minute wavering sounds on the sirens or a series of short blasts on whistles, horns, or other devices. This means that an actual enemy attack against the United States has been detected and that protective action should be initiated immediately. The amount of time you and your family will have to prepare yourselves could be as little as 5 minutes in some locations or as long as an hour in others.
Regardless of the amount of time you have, use it wisely and...
Peter, on use it wisely, can you give us a change of emphasis?
Yeah, you're right. Use it wisely. Let me try it again. Do you want it from the top or in the middle, okay?
Roll into it.
Okay, right. The amount of time you and your family will have to prepare yourselves could be as little as 5 minutes, or in some locations, as long as an hour. Regardless of the amount of time you have, use it wisely. Yeah. In calm preparation.
Take advantage of the warning you get. Immediately turn on the radio and follow the official instructions you hear.
Yeah, that's good.
Okay. Maybe a little heavy would kill it, huh?
Yeah, I think. Let's go on to the next section, and here it gets a little heavier. We're trying to emphasize the magnitude of the blast and whatnot.
Yeah, and there again, you know, you could scare people with all the horrible details. What do you think? Would you still underplay it?
Yeah, Marilyn?
I think so.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's hard to really underplay because the words are so strong, you know, and... Well, let's give it a whirl and see what we can come up with.
The picture here, I know you haven't seen it, you're doing it wild. The picture will show mushrooms, mm-hmm. and will show devastation, and as opposed to all of the other films we've been doing, the devastation here is quite frightening.
Mm-hmm. So sort of counterpoint it by, yeah, if we are heavy and the picture is heavy, then it'll be just doomsday, right?
To coin a phrase.
Yeah.
I think the significance here is that I think we want the audience to recognize that they have a personal responsibility to themselves and to their community. And it's right near the end of the film, and it's really a wind-up leading towards the very emotional end of the film. Okay, now, let's try it again, please.
Right. It is obvious that the aftermath of a nuclear attack will not be a pretty sight. But survival of the blast requires each citizen to act with common sense and responsibility. For each individual must become part of an effort to get the community and the nation back to normal as quickly as possible.
That's good. Pretty frightening. What do you think? Al, you in there?
Yeah, hold it. I have a funny feeling that... the rest of the narration should be out on location. I don't think we should do it as voiceover. I think that we have to go back to a location, go back to something that becomes significant. What do you think, Roger?
What do you suggest?
Well, we shot before in front of Lincoln, and then we had Washington Memorial and all. I was thinking of something like either the Capitol or White House, something like that.
Well, as long as we're doing it, why don't we try for the White House?
Yeah, the White House.
Yeah.
I like it.
Okay.
Can we
easy,
get the White House?
Sure. Yeah. Let me call up Ed.
Peter?
Got some changes, Peter.
Okay.
You're not going to believe it, but we're moving location.
You what?
Moving location.
Moving location. Where to?
Have you been to the White House?
I passed it. I've never been there.
Okay.
Is that where we're going?
We may.
Here we are in beautiful downtown Washington.
Right.
Are you sure you want to make this on camera?
Yeah, come on, Petey. We made the White House. Look at the fallout. Okay.
Beautiful. Let's go back to Riddell's.
Okay, you ready? Okay.
I'm ready. Okay.
You want to do a sound level? Let's get
it. Yeah, checking. 1, 2, 3. Here we are in front of the White House. Does it look okay? Okay.
Focus. I want to slate it.
All right.
Are you ready? You do a slate.
That's all right. Part of the atmosphere.
Are we ready? Yeah. Okay. Nuclear disaster. Same 33. Take one. Roll one. Roll four. Okay. White. We start white, right? Okay.
The thought of a nuclear attack and its aftermath is so terrible that...
Let me see if I can get this on. Okay.
Look okay?
Okay.
You gonna pick up rattle in the jacket?
Dan, how is that?
You get anything?
It's okay. You wanna give me a level?
1, 2. Checking. Here we are in downtown Washington.
You wanna do a slate on this? You got the focus? Is focus okay, George? Yeah, I've been rolling. Okay, very good. Nuclear disaster, scene 33. Take one. Roll four.
Okay.
Okay, all right,
we're ready. The thought of a nuclear attack and its aftermath is so terrible that most people have put it out of their minds. But not thinking about it and not really thinking seriously about it, it will not make a danger disappear. It only makes, well, preparation impossible. And this can be fatal, for preparation, which of course can save your life, can only be done in advance of an emergency situation. Hoping to really prepare when something unexpected occurs is futile because
Can I start? Let's try it again.
Let's wait till this thing stops.
Let's wait till it stops, okay?
Okay. Yeah. Some luck. Oh, we can always shout over it. Yeah, how about that? But not thinking about it.